Hi guys, this is Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. Welcome to this video. In this video, we're going to show you how to add a logo to your secondary menu in the Divi theme. Divi theme is awesome, but it kind of presumes that you just want to add a logo to your lower main menu there. So let's get started. Let's go to our dashboard and just add a logo, just so we can show you what's going on here. If we go to the dashboard, down to Divi, and then to Theme Options. There, you're going to, under the General tab, there you're going to find the logo. So if we hit the Upload button, and we'll drag in our logo file. Then we'll hit the Set as Logo button. Save our changes. And let's go back to the site and refresh. There it is, that's put our logo in there in the normal position that Divi presumes that you want to put it. Let's add our secondary menu that sits just above the primary menu here. If we go back to our dashboard. So once we're back to the dashboard, let's create a quick menu for it. If we go to Appearance, Themes and Menus. And we'll click on the Create a New Menu link. And we'll call it Top. And Create Menu. Now we just need to add some pages. So let's just add some random pages to it. And save our menu. Now that we've created the menu, we go to our Divi Theme Customizer. And once it's loaded, we'll go down to Menus. And here's our top menu we've just created. And we want it to display in the secondary menu. So if we check the box down below here that says secondary menu. There we are, our menu's appeared at the top there. Let's get rid of that background color. I'll make it the same color as the lower one here, white. So if we go back. And to header and navigation, to secondary menu bar. Change that background color to white. And we'll make the text color blue so we can see it. And make it a little bit bigger, say 16. Okay, so let's save and publish. Now we have that secondary menu bar up there. What we want to do is put this logo on the top bar there, on this new menu that we've just, on this new nav bar that we've just created here. We still want all these objects down below, but we just want to move this logo up to the top there. And that's not as difficult as you may think. So what we want to do now is we want to go down to the header and navigation section again. Go to our primary menu bar, which is this lower one right here with the logo and the search form on there. And we want to check the little box that says hide logo image. So that's got rid of it, but you will notice if you scroll, it comes back again, and we don't want that. So if we go back one, and we go down to fixed navigation settings, and we'll check the little box there that says hide logo also. Now when we scroll down, the logo is no longer there. Without it checked, when we scroll, it appears. So we don't want that because we're going to put it on this other menu right here. So we'll check that. We'll save and publish. Okay, now let's actually put our logo in the top bar here. So let's go back to our dashboard. We can close out the customizer. What we want to do is create a page. We don't have to publish it. We can make it a draft. Call it whatever you like. And we'll just save the draft. Now we want to find our logo that we were using in our primary menu bar, which will be in our media. So we'll hit add media. There it is. So just add that to the page. There's our logo right there. Now what we need to do is switch over from visual to the text tab. Here's the code we want to copy right here. From the beginning of the A tag to the end of the A tag there. Just want to copy that one. Just hit the save draft button. Now if we go to our appearance and then down to the menus, in that menu that we just created, we're going to add a custom link to it. So here's the custom links. We just drop down a little bit. Got to put something in there. Usually put the index or the root of your site, so every time somebody clicks on your logo, it'll go back to your home page. I'm just going to put that in there. Now, where it says link text, this is where we want to paste that code that we've just copied from our page and add it to the menu. There it is at the bottom. Looks a bit messy, but that's fine. Just going to left click and drag it up to the top because we want it on the left hand side there. Now, if we save the menu and we go back and visit our site, there's our logo. It's not exactly where we want it, but we can reposition it. Okay, so now we've got the logo up there. What we're going to do is position it where we want it. So let's just right click and inspect. There's our logo. Where's our actual section there? Secondary menu. That's our secondary menu there. And it says float right. Let's float it to the left so it's on the left hand side. There we go. That's a bit better. And what we want to do is make that width 100% so we can spread these out a bit if we need to. So let's just add width. Check that. Yep, that's made that 100%. And the secondary nav just below it, we really want to make that 100% as well, or else that's not going to work. So yep, that's made that. So if we go back to that, we want to copy that. Go into our custom CSS in our Divi theme, which is under theme options, custom CSS. And let's make a new entry here. /**/. And we'll call it top nav with a logo. Make it easier for us to find it later. Paste in that bit of CSS that we just copied, and we also want that secondary piece, which was secondary nav. So I'm just going to copy that first piece and change the last thing to nav instead of menu, because that's not an element in its own right over here. Well, I guess it is right there without that, but let's do it the easy way. So we'll just copy that over again. Down one or two, just give ourselves a bit of space here. Change that to nav. And we don't want the float left, we do want the width 100%. So there we go, save changes. And do a refresh, and that should leave it pretty much like it is here. Okay, that's all right. That's what we were looking for. This is looking a bit scruffy next to the logo. We really want it sort of centralized. I mean, obviously you can get rid of that because it's just a duplicate of this, but if you do have stuff you want to put there, I'll show you how to make it look a little tidier. And what we've got to do that, I think we're going to have to add some padding to this so it actually drops down, and then select that and push it up a little bit. Let's have a look, see, let's just inspect this. List items. Yeah, that looks about it. So if we give it some padding on the top, it'll push it down a bit. So let's see. Try 30 picks. Let's push it down. I don't quite know if that's going to be enough, but we'll try that for a start. So we'll copy this and add it to our style sheet, just below the last entry here. And of course, remember to put that curly bracket on the bottom because I didn't copy the whole thing. Okay, let's make a bit more space there and roll this up. Save our changes. Back to the site, refresh it just to make sure it's going to stay there. Okay, that's good. What we want to do is adjust this so that it goes up a bit, and that'll take everything up a bit. And we want to adjust it so it's not got the padding below. So let's have a look at this. If I just inspect this, and we look at this line here, actually it's just the line just above here. So it's menu item 458. So let's just copy that. That's a class, as you can see, class. So I'm going to right-click and edit as HTML. I mean, obviously, you can just copy it if you want to. I mean, just type it in there. Well, I'm just going to copy that. Go back to our custom CSS. Drop down another one. And I'm going to put period and then paste in that class there because it's a class. We just put a period in front of it. And then open the curly brackets and close the curly brackets. Drop down a couple, give it some space. Now, if we look back at our site, we can't do this in real time because anything I do to that is going to affect all of these. So we'll do a bit of guesswork. And we know we've put padding on the bottom of all of them of 35 pics or 30 pics, wasn't it? So what we need to do is put padding on the top of this one to 0. So let's go back in there and try 0% or 0 pics, semicolon. And save changes. Let's see what that's done. When we refresh, hopefully that should pull up a bit. Well, actually, that will stay pretty central, but these will pull up a bit. Let's try it. No, that didn't do anything. Okay. Let's give it the important class after that. And that may force it to do it. And save changing. Just look, make sure I haven't spelt anything wrong there, because I'm sure you know if you spell things wrong, things don't tend to work. Now if we refresh, that's better. It's pulled it up some there, but okay, I'm not quite sure. That should have pulled that up there. Maybe need to float this left. Let's have a look, see. Yeah, that's done it. We need to float that element left, so I'm just going to copy that float left and put it in here. Again, we may have to use that important class or that important attribute to make it work. We'll see if that actually works. See if this stays where it is. Yeah, that's fine. We don't need that important attribute. Okay, so that logo is pretty much where we want it there. Let's push these back over this way a little bit so they're separated from the logo a bit. I think we can drop them down a little bit more too. So if we go back to our CSS, let's change that to, say, 35. And what I'm going to do is give our menu item 458, which is our logo, I'm going to give it some padding right. But this time I'm going to use a percentage instead of a pixel, say 20%. So it'll push that, so it'll push those other menu items to the right. And because I'm using a percentage rather than a pixel value, when the screen shrinks down on smaller sizes, it should stay, it'll still be 20% rather than 200 pixels, which will shrink accordingly. So let's save that and see if it actually works there. And refresh. Yep, that's pushed it over nicely. Okay, so that's pretty much it, really. I mean, it looks a bit weird having this on the right side. What if we were to float this right? I mean, we can go on and on and editing. Obviously, you need to fix it the way you want to fix things. Yeah, we've got float right there, top nav right. What if we go left? That's better. Don't like that search box there, but we can sort that out with a menu. So let's just copy that bit there. Back to our style sheet, drop down a couple, paste that in there, save it, just make sure it's going to work by refreshing. Yep, okay, but like I say, I don't like that there. Let's just chuck this search bar on that end. That might make it look a little more visually effective. Okay, so that's easily to do. If we go back to our theme options and go up to our menu or appearance and then menu. And that's our top one, so we don't want that menu. We want the primary menu, so select that one. Here's our search bar. Let's just left click and drag it down to the bottom. Save that. Quick refresh. Yeah, that looks a bit better. Obviously, you put it how you want to do it. It's entirely up to you. We could actually shrink that down a bit so there's not so much space there. And again, just go to your Divi theme or customizer. And header and navigation. That's actually our primary menu. And let's just pull the menu height back some. Pretty much all the way. I don't know if that affected it or not. No, that doesn't affect it. And that'll sort of make a little less space there. So save and publish. Back to our site to close the inspector there. And a quick refresh. And there you have it. We've now got our Divi logo in our top menu there, which is the secondary menu with Divi. So that is how you do it. I hope that's been helpful to you. Once again, this has been Jamie from System22 and GreatWebDesign.com. Thanks for watching. Have a great day.